I mentioned at the beginning of every show about being the change, and when Gandhi said that, I mean, there's a whole library of wisdom in that little statement, and it's so true. When you're able to change that on the inside, the universe just has no choice but to surround you with that, to embrace you.
Well, we know
like
the field.
It does.
It's precisely the field must conform to what it is that we create in our hearts, and it's doing so now. We live in a country since a post 9/11 world where we have been conditioned in a number of different ways to live in a very fearful world. So there's a tension. You can feel the tension in this country, and a lot of people don't know it because we're so used to it. But when you leave this country and you go into another part of the world, people say to me, it just feels different here. You know, what is it? It feels there's an ease. They're not living under the same tension. I'm not saying it's right, wrong, good, or bad. I'm saying it's a fact that we live. I mean, when you walk into any airport in our country, within 10 minutes, you're being told to look suspiciously at other people, report any suspicious people to the nearest law enforcement officers, and you're told that there's a threat level, one threat level just in general life, and then there's an elevated threat level before you get onto the plane that's for aviation only, and then have a nice day. I mean, you know, what do we do with that?
Right, and you know, and in between, your shoes are off, your belt's off, you. I mean, it's
I just saw people coming to the airport in their pajamas, no kidding, and they had their clothes in their carry-on, and they felt like it was going to be easier just to go through, and some, they were modest PJs, and then get dressed in the bathroom after security. It was just easier to do it that way.
I tried to travel comfortable now, because I used to travel and I, you know, look fine. I'd be wearing a shirt, and it's all pressed, and I was all. By the time I went through, it looked like I had been in a wrestling match, and it makes sense what they did. But even Greg, even if you go to say like Canada, I mean, the other side of the border, that sense of ease. You're absolutely right, and a lot in this society also, aside from the fear, there's not a lot of empowering information. There is in the sense of books and stuff, but most of the time you'll hear, even with the terrorism and everything else, people feel very disempowered.
Absolutely, and I just want to be really clear here, Steve. I'm not saying that it's anybody's fault, and I'm not saying it's a right, wrong, good, or bad. I'm pointing out the fact that we are living right now in a fear-based society. Since 9/11, our country has been sicker than... and that's what the statistics show. There's been a 100% increase in pharmaceutical sales since 9/11 as a result of the illness that is created from living continuously in fight or flight, in fear, where the adrenaline is pumped to some degree, where we're feeling that there's something that out there, but we can't resolve it.
Right.
It's not that way in other parts of the world. And where this becomes important is if we're saying this field out there mirrors what we feel, and we are living in fear, it's not surprising then to see that fear coming back to us in greater and stronger ways, you know, more extremes. And we know what happens if we live in a world where we feel separate from one another, where we feel that there's only so much of the pie to go around, that we've got to fight for our share, we have to live in fear. We know what happens because that's the world we've lived in, and we know what we've created. What the experiments are showing, what the science is telling us, what the ancient wisdom says, is that can change in a heartbeat. The same principles can apply in reverse. If we begin to live in this world from a place of cooperation, if we recognize that it's not about grabbing our share of the pie, but it's about sharing what we have to help us all become better people because we're a family, then the experiments suggest, the studies support, and the ancient traditions say that the world will mirror that back to us in a heartbeat. And it can happen that quickly. It's just that subtle, pivotal point where we begin to feel differently about who we are in this universe, and that is where this science, the new science, married with the ancient wisdom, fleshes out a greater story of who we are. And I think that's what this time in history is all about.
Well, because when you change your agreement with reality, also you see things. I mean, the world itself, you can have the same world the next day, but if your agreement with reality is different, what you actually see and notice, don't forget that, and Greg, I'm sure will agree, that when you have a certain agreement with reality, you only see things that validate that agreement with reality.
Well, precisely. We actually talk about this in a new book that will be released next year. The bottom line in a single sentence is that we tend to experience what we identify with. So everything
right.
is happening, but we tend to experience what we identify with. And our listeners already know this. I mean, if you've ever, a few years ago, I had an experience. I was living in Colorado at the time, and I was looking for a new vehicle, a Jeep Cherokee. I thought they were pretty unique. Didn't know much about them. Went out to the dealerships, and I learned about the different models and what the features were. And, Steve, no, I mean, I kid you not, no sooner than I'd left that dealership, and I was driving on the freeways, and all of a sudden, I saw Jeep Cherokees everywhere. They were on the freeway. They were in the Safeway parking lot. They'd always been there. There was just nothing within me that brought them into my awareness. So they blended in to the static of everyday life. And once they became a focus of my attention, then that focus showed up everywhere. And it's the same. Are there scary things in our world? Absolutely. And the flip side of that is there are many reasons to feel safe, many reasons to feel empowered, many reasons to feel healed, and our bodies will respond to that healing almost immediately. And this is what one of the things we're showing. I've got a new book that will be out in April of next year where we case history after case history talking about these things.
And for those of you who are IMing me about the current book that I was talking about, The Divine Matrix, yes, I've read it, and I've read it a few times, and you can get that through Greg Braden's site. That's gregbraden.com, GREGGBRADEN.com. We're speaking with Greg Braden. He has, for over 20 years, has searched the high mountain villages, remote monasteries, and forgotten texts to uncover their timeless secrets. He is amazing at just bridging this gap between science and spirituality, and I strongly suggest you get the book. When we get back, we'll go into the last quarter of the show, and we'll talk to Greg more about the power you have to create and shape your life. You're listening to Empowered Living. We'll be right back.